To evening prayer for the Tuesday the 23rd of April in the fourth week of Easter. Today all music is from the Abbey in Iona in honor of our friend Tom Schumann, whose birthday it is today. So if you would like to leave some well wishes, you're free and welcome to do so. Our opening praise: O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us. Your word is a lantern to my feet and a light upon my path. Your decrees are my inheritance forever. Truly they are the joy of my heart. How sweet are your words to my taste. They are sweeter than honey to my mouth. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. And tonight's psalm is Psalm 66, and as usually I read it as a canticle by Tom Schumann. We open our mouths and want to sing praises, as we know we should, but with so much dryness, with lips cracked with fears, with aching and worried hearts, it becomes so hard, our God, and yet we know that you have not given up. You have not been pensioned. You are still busy as ever, imagining, creating, putting together the life we need these days, the peace which can mend cracks, the grace which can calm fears. Continue, our God, to touch us with your hope, that we may sing of justice, to caress us with your grace, that we may learn new songs of mercy, to comfort us as our dearest friend, that we may share the burdens of others as you help to carry all which weighs us down. And whether alone or with all we know, whether tomorrow or in the future, Whether afraid or with confidence, we will offer justice, love, and healing as our sacrifices of praise, even as we sing our tentative songs to you, knowing you are still listening. You gather every word to your heart. You refuse to take away that love, which is the foundation of our lives. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. And yes, Stella, there are many, many birthdays today. Indeed. Our first reading is from Exodus 32, verses 21 to 34. It is a difficult reading, but I'll read it anyway. So, Moses said to Aaron, "What did this people do to you that you have brought so great a sin upon them?" And Aaron said, "Do not let the anger of my Lord burn hot. You know the people, that they are bent on evil. They said to me, 'Make us gods who shall go before us.' As for this Moses, the man who brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we do not know what has become of him." So I said to them, "Whoever has gold, take it off." So they gave it to me, and I threw it into the fire, and out came this calf. When Moses saw that the people were running wild, for Aaron had let them run wild, to the derision of their enemies, then Moses stood in the gate of the camp and said, "Who is on the Lord's side? Come to me." And all the sons of Levi gathered around him. He said to them, "Thus says the Lord, the God of Israel, put your sword on your side, each of you. Go back and forth from gate to gate throughout the camp, and each of you kill your brother, your friend, and your neighbor." The sons of Levi did as Moses commanded, and about 3,000 of the people fell on that day. Moses said, "Today you have ordained yourselves for the service of the Lord, each one at the cost of a son or a brother, and so have brought a blessing on yourselves this day." On the next day, Moses said to the people, "You have sinned a great sin, but now I will go up to the Lord. Perhaps I can make atonement for your sin." So Moses returned to the Lord and said, "Alas, this people has sinned a great sin. They have made for themselves gods of gold, but now if you will only forgive their sin. But if not, blot me out of the book that you have written." But the Lord said to Moses, "Whoever has sinned against me, I will blot out of my book. But now go lead the people to the place about which I have spoken to you. See, my angel shall go in front of you. Nevertheless, when the day comes for punishment, I will punish them for their sin." Our next reading is from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 5, 11 to 16. "Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. You are the salt of the earth, but if salt has lost its taste, how can its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything, but it's thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under the bushel basket, but on the lampstand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your lights shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. So we've just read about 3,000 being killed because of having sinned against the Lord, making a gold god instead of having faith that Moses would return and that God would lead them to the promised land. I really cannot say much that makes any sense about this, really. Perhaps that if there is sin, it's just not that you're just simply forgiven. That's not, Jesus died to have our sins be forgiven. And, well, here are 3,000. You don't get it for free. That's the thought that I get when I read this. You don't get your salvation for free. But God gave it through Jesus. And Tom writes about, you are the light of the world, a city built on a hill cannot be hid. Verse 14 in Matthew 5. And he writes, you wander through the bombed out communities in Ukraine, carrying a tiny flickering candle of peace. In a rubble strewn hospital somewhere in Gaza, you hold steady a single light to enable the surgeons to see in every shadow of worry, under every rock which we use to try to hide ourselves. In the lengthy evening of dread, creeping across the lawns of every soul in every place, you try to create that beloved community of hope, of grace, of inclusion, of justice, praying we might bring our lights to merge with yours. Amen. The New Testament song is a song of love. 1 John 4:7-11. God is love. Beloved, let us love one another. Because love is from God, everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. God's love was revealed among us in this way. God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us, and sent his Son to be the atoning sacrifice for our sins. Beloved, since God loved us so much, we also ought to love one another. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And I just realized that this is exactly what I wanted to say earlier in my rather simple way. So let us pray. And for prayer, I'm going again to read from Our Faith Wobbles by Tom Schumann. And the evening prayer. For what shall we pray tonight? Come, protect us this night, O God, from all the fears prowling around us, from all the worries hiding in the closets of our mind. For what shall we pray this night? Come and fill us this night, Jesus of the evening, with the hope which cradles us, with the grace which pillows our heads, with that love which is a warm blanket. For what shall we pray this night? Come and keep us this night, O Spirit, with that peace which calms us, with that kindness which wraps around us, with the compassion which is a balm for our wounds. For what shall we pray this night? Come, God, in community, holy in one, to be with us, to watch over us, to bring us this night into the nearness of your love. Amen. Also, we pray for a week of peace, while our Jewish brothers and sisters celebrate Passover with their families, while they see the empty seats where their beloved ones should sit but are still held captive. Alongside them, we pray for the victims of all war and attacks, all drafts and national disaster. And tonight, on the World Day of the Book, we pray for the writers, the authors, the creators of texts that inspire us, that make a lasting impression on us, that change our lives. We also give thanks for one such writer, our dear friend Tom Schumann, who shares his birthday with William Shakespeare. We give thanks to you, Lord, for his inspiration, his faith and compassion, his writing and ministry that gives so much understanding of your word and comfort in times of need. We give thanks for his generosity to share all of this with us through evening prayer here at URC live stream. And we pray for his life, his beloved Bonnie and Teddy, and we pray for his good health and many more years of his friendship. In the cycle of prayer for the East Midlands Synod tonight, we pray for the ministers, elders, and members of our churches in Leicestershire. And we also pray for those who have been asked to pray for Elaine Drey, secretary of our former Irvine URC, and her pain and anxiety as she awaits surgery. For June Pevy, for Graham Garlip, following surgery, giving thanks for the medical team and praying for his recovery. For the Reverend Caroline Andrews. For Roger Allen and for the Reverend Ruth Allen in her care and concern for him. With Brenda Kenyon, for Ron Kenyon. With Celia, for her grandson Alfie, for his recovery. And with Tom, for Sam, recovering from a medical emergency. We pray with Allison for her parents, Reverend Brian Russell and Dorothy Russell. We pray for Barbara Turner of Holy Moorside URC as she awaits surgery. For the Reverend Helen Wakefield Carr and her ongoing cancer treatment. For the Reverend Liz Adams and for the Reverend Hamish Temple for recovery from surgery. For Jean Schenck and for the Reverend Brian Schenck and his care and concern for her. For the Reverend Graham and Vera Masquerie and for Father Andy, Moina Hobart's parish priest. With me for my friend Bea. With the Reverend Claire and Reverend Brian Davison for Susie, their daughter. For Cheryl and for Prince and the family in their ongoing care for her. With Andy for Mikey's dad and for Liz and Ruth in their ongoing care of him. For John and for Irene as she continues to look after him. We also pray for the members of the royal family for recovery from illness and for good health. We also pray for those who grieve, especially for Alison's sister Carolyn on the death of Carolyn's husband Steve. Also with Alison's husband Paul and his dad Roy and all the family on the death of Paul's mum Pat. For those who grieve for Don Buxton, especially the Reverend Maureen Buxton. For all who grieve, for Bishop Alan Wilson, especially his wife Lucy and the family. For all who grieve the passing of loved ones. And for ourselves and for the world, please join me in saying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as those who trespass against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
This is God's world.
And we will serve God in it.
May God's blessing rest on us. May God's care surround us. And may God lead our lives with love.
Thank you.
The Lord bless us with his grace and fill us with his peace. Amen. Good night.